Hi there. The word for today is your setback can lead to a comeback. In 1 Corinthians 15 verse 57, the Apostle Paul writes, "But thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." What seems like a setback is often just a setup for a comeback. There's no greater illustration of this than Good Friday. On the Saturday between Good Friday and Resurrection Sunday, it seemed like all was lost, didn't it? But it's not over until God says it's over. The greatest spiritual victory in history was won on the heels of its seemingly greatest defeat. All was lost, but not for long. 3 days after his crucifixion, Jesus walked out of his tomb. And as a redeemed child of God, that same power lives in you today. Did you know that? Romans 8 verse 11 says, "If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, then he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal body, to your sick body, to your needy body, through his spirit who dwells in you." In God's kingdom, failure is never final, not if you believe in the resurrection. Now you won't win every spiritual battle, but the war has been decisively won. The victory was sealed 2,000 years ago when Jesus broke the seal of death and left that tomb. It was the death blow to death itself. Paul writes, verse 37 of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, "Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us." Today, you are more than a conqueror in what? In all these things, whatever it is you're going through, because of what Christ accomplished for you. Yeah, you'll experience setbacks, but remember this. Without a crucifixion, there can be no resurrection. So, when you have a setback, don't take a step back, because God is preparing your comeback. And that is the word for you today.
I believe in the sun. I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome by the power his blood. Amen. Amen. I'm alive because he lived. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the world that never ends, because he lived. Was dead in the grave. I was covered in sin and shame. I heard mercy call my